Good morning and welcome to another edition of Short Bites with Pastor Larry Vimal here in Redlands. How do I fight? How do I fight my battles? How do I navigate this life? We have to have some understanding as a Christian. In 1 Samuel 17:47, David says the battle is the Lord's. And the context of that is he's about ready to go fight Goliath. So even though David is saying the battle is the Lord's, David still had to go pick up some stones and throw them at Goliath. And so we have to understand, is this something I sit back and let God take care of? Or does God say that I'm going to give you the power to overcome the situation? So we have to have some understanding. In 2 Samuel, later on, David is now king. In 2 Samuel 5:20. David's going to go to battle, and he's got his army, and they're waiting. And David inquires of the Lord and says, "Lord, what should I do?" And the Lord says, "When you hear the sound of marching feet in the trees above your head, you'll know that the Lord of hosts has went before you. Go out and do battle, for you will win." So David still had his army. They still had to go out with swords and spears. But the Lord said, "I'm going to go before you so you win." So those were Old Testament. Those were pre-cross. But we have to have the connotation. What is the Lord fighting for us? So I have to understand that Jesus at the cross destroyed all the power the enemy has over you. He took back the keys of death and hell. And he took away all the separation between the Father and us. So Jesus did that. But now how do I navigate from that new position as a Christian? So in Luke 10:19, Jesus says, "I've given you authority to walk on snakes and scorpions." So I'm not to be afraid of the enemy. I have authority to walk on the enemy. But I need to know how to do that. So in Mark 16:17, it says, "In my name they will cast out demons." Now, the qualification is those who believe in me will cast out demons. So it doesn't mean you have to be a super Christian, the biggest giver in the church, or be as white as snow in the natural realm, because spiritually you are perfect. And so we need to get up and take our authority so I can cast out demons. If I have strongholds in my life, it is going to be very hard for me to overcome anything. And so I'm not waiting for God to deliver me from the stronghold. I am going to speak over the stronghold, or I'm going to go to a church that has that ability, or, you know, my pastors or whatever it is, and get the strongholds tore down inside of me. In Philippians 4:13, it says, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." So when I go to battle, whatever the battle is, it's an addiction, it's finances, it's health or whatever it is, I'm going to battle with Jesus, because I am born again. So the life I live hidden in Christ, and Christ in me, the hope of glory. So I can do all things through him. Now in Galatians 5:24, it says, "Now those who belong to Christ just crucify the flesh with his passions and desires." So am I dealing with a demonic stronghold? Am I dealing with something that I'm supposed to let the Lord take care of? Or is this something that I need to crucify my flesh? And in James 4:7, it says, "Resist the devil and he will flee." I've had many strongholds in my life, and Heather can testify to that. And so to start with, I had to have a biblical foundation of who am I in Christ. And then we had to tear down the strongholds. And so now when the enemy throws a dart to go back to some other thing, some other stronghold, some addiction of the past, I have to crucify the flesh. And I do that with the words I speak. I say, "No, that isn't me. I'm not going to go back to whatever that bad habit is." So as you're walking out your day today, understand how righteous you are, understand how much God loves you, and understand the authority you have, and then discern by the Holy Spirit, is this something I need to resist? Is this something I need to call down a stronghold on? Or is this something, good morning, all my friends are watching, or is this something that I sit back and the Lord is going to take care of? So we need to discern, how to go into battle and what God wants me to do in this situation. I pray that you'd look into these things and be blessed by the word the Lord gave me this morning. Just know that you are loved and God's plan for you is greater than any plan that you have. Have a blessed day, my friends. Have a good one. We'll see you next time.